Hello, friends. I just came across a cool kind of technique using Unity to render a skybox from an in-game scene. So traditionally, if you had kind of a vast environment for a PC game, obviously you might go ahead and just use LOD groups and have everything rendered in real time. But increasingly, we're seeing VR and mobile. It really needs to have you want to have good looking stuff, but you can't render all that, right? So especially with VR, I guess that's how I came across this, was using a plugin for Maya. You can create a scene like this, have tons and tons of geometry in your Maya scene that are high resolution geometry, and you might spend a couple hours rendering out this this beautiful kind of spherically mapped image. And then just texture map that onto a inside out sphere, a sphere that has inverse normals. And there are some plugins for Maya that allow you to do that. And it's great for VR if your scene is just maybe it's just maybe 3D video, or you're not rendering any 3D objects in your scene with your kind of skybox. So I needed a way to create a scene in Unity that looks, using the same assets, the same objects, and have the same lighting. That was the key. And then to create a composition that will look correct w between objects that are really being rendered and objects that are not being rendered, that are static in the actual image on the skybox. So I came across this cool thing. And so I'm just going to go through real quick the way I did it. This scene, obviously there's tons and tons of trees here, and these are all geometry. So I guess I can turn off the fog to see what the scene actually looks like from the top. So you can see that obviously you would not be able to render that in mobile, but I wanted to be able to see that same kind of effect. I want to have a forest that I cannot see out of, and I don't want to have to create terrain and all that real objects. So the other cool thing about this technique is that you can use the post-processing stack to render your outside world. So I have on my camera set up the same, using the post-processing stack, and see if I find the, yeah. So I've enabled anti-aliasing. I pumped it up. I'm using the deferred rendering on this camera, bloom and color grading, but I'm using the same light, and you can even bake this in the same way using the same baking techniques. I didn't want to do that for this because it would take forever to bake this scene, but you can use real-time lighting to do it too, so you don't even really need to bake it. So anyway, you create the scene the way that you would want it to be viewed, and for me, I wanted to have kind of a foggy, dense forest, and then I placed my camera in the center of it, and I found Unity has built-in function called render to cube map. So you guys may already know this. I just thought I found it. It's so cool that you can they give you a script even to start with. So I just copy pasted this script that you can give it in this version. You give it a transform and a cube map, and it will take whatever that camera sees and put it onto basically a skybox texture. So I'll show you how to go about doing that using Unity. So really, I guess the first thing is to grab that script and just create it in, in here. And for me, I by default, that script creates a camera and renders from it. But I wanted to be able to use that post-processing stuff, and I also wanted to modify the near and far clipping plane. This is what I originally did, but I eventually went to just giving it an actual camera. So I have some code in here that will, if I don't give it a camera, then it will create the camera like the script originally did. But if I do give it a camera, all it does is use that camera to render the cube map. So once you've got the script set up, then you go to create legacy cube map, and that'll give you this little cube map guy here. And that cube map kind of acts just like a skybox. It's got your six sides there. And then you create a texture, or I'm sorry, a material, create material, and then you set that material shader to skybox cube map, and then you drag and drop your cube map onto that guy right there. And so here's now where the magic happens. You go to game object, and you'll now have the render to cube map option here, because that's provided by this script, and that gives you this little wizard guy that you drag in the camera that's got your post-processing stuff on it. You give it your cube map, and I don't need to transform, and you can override this. I decided to override it because I want to render everything in the whole scene. And then when you render it, it gives you an accurate representation of what that camera is seeing, and it's pretty darn cool. I mean, it's really pretty great, because I have a really good looking image without all the geometry. So now I'll go look at what that looks like in my scene. So in the scene, you don't want to have nothing in the background moving, especially in this situation where we're dealing with trees. So what I did here was I used that material as my skybox. So this is just using that cube map on my lighting tab. I went and grabbed that cube map material and put it onto my skybox. So I'm using that cube map as a skybox. But then we've got the actual scene. I'm lost. Okay. We'll go to the cat. Hey, kitty. But I did place some of those trees around, those same trees that I used to render, and they do have LOD groups on them, so they're fairly performant already. But just enough, so it's still renderable by a mobile device, but just enough so that when I'm running around, there are trees that move with the character, because otherwise you'll get this kind of eerie background that doesn't move. So now we've got trees in the scene that are nearer to the player, that are moving and that are rendered by the engine. So they look pretty real, but since they're the exact same trees that were used to make the skybox, you get this really pretty decent composition between the two. So really, just looking at this, it's fairly difficult to differentiate between the ones that are real and the ones that are in the background. So I think it was pretty cool. And obviously this was pretty quick and dirty. There's some other stuff that you could do with cleaning it up a little bit more. But at least this, for me, it got the effect that I wanted in this game, that I was looking for. So I hope that helps. And yeah, thanks a lot.